There is always a little bit of an issue, and we really wonder whether we are making too much out of this, because too much knowledge is dangerous. If most of us have never heard of pseudodendrites, and we treat patients with a dendritic picture with antivirals, we are usually doing no harm, because most of the time you will be right and they will be dendrites, because they're not, these pseudodendrites are not as common. But let's see which situations you should stop and pause and think before you put the patient on the antivirals. So herpes simplex, we know HSV keratitis is the most frequent cause of blindness due to corneal disease in the US, and the most common source of infectious blindness in the developed countries. Here, of course, we have fungus, which takes top honors on the podium. The prognosis in HSV keratitis, however, is generally favorable with aggressive treatment. So should we be treating everybody with antivirals? The dendritic ulcer, the earliest sign of active viral replication in the corneal epithelium is the developed. See, what happens is you don't get an ulcer first. You get something like small raised clear vesicles which don't stain with fluorescein. But in approximately 24 hours, these vesicles then coalesce. They group together to form the classical dendrite form that most of us recognize and which stains very well, as you can see in the pictures below. So they are the most, dendritic ulcers are the most common presentation of HSV keratitis. In epithelial keratitis, you will either get a dendritic pattern or you'll get a geographic ulcer. These are the most common. Again, dendritic can lead to geographic ulcers as well. What are the prominent features of a classic dendritic ulcer? It's a linear branching pattern with terminal bulbs at the ends of the branches. So if you go into high power on the slit lamp, at the end of the branch, if you can see the rose Bengal stained one, at the end of it, it's a terminal end bulb at the end, which stained brightly with fluorescein. And there are swollen epithelial borders of the branches. So the branches, the borders of the branches are swollen. The ends are bulbous. And in the center of that, there is a central ulceration which goes through the basement membrane. And usually these are unilateral. So again, to mention the classical features, terminal bulbs, bright staining at the borders of the branch, and there is a central ulceration at the base, which goes right up to the basement membrane and usually unilateral. Why do we get dendrites in HSV? What happens is the virus bounces. This is something like a poet having described this. The virus bounces from cell to cell. So each lesion develops one cell at a time, which is why you get this linear lesion, because there are cells falling out and virus cells filling in. So they knock off the original epithelial cells and the virus cells come and take their place. And because it's moving in a drunken manner, you get this dendritic pattern. Immune compromised, this is for immune competent patients. Immune compromised patients may have non-classical features. They may have only the vesicles which last for beyond 24 hours and no dendrite ever forming. On the other hand, patients with a recurrent keratitis, fourth, fifth attack of HSV keratitis, even with intact immune systems, may have these vesicles early on in a recurrence prior to examination. And so by the time you see them, you'll see them with dendrites itself. So these are some of the variations in dendrites. So how do we diagnose this? We don't need to do PCR for all these patients. Primarily, it's a clinical diagnosis. You can stain with fluorescein, stain with rose Bengal, and you get classical features. If you scrape, you can do a GIMSA scan, you can do a pap smear, you can do viral cultures, immunohistochemistry, depending on what kind of solo practice to an institute base, and you want to write a paper on the subject, then of course you can do all these other tests as well. Let's move on to pseudodendrites, having learned enough about the dendrites. Now, many epithelial lesions, which are not HSV, also have a dendritic shape. Although most of these lesions are therefore called pseudodendrites, pseudodendrites is a basket or a waste paper basket diagnosis, I would call. First, we misdiagnose everything as HSV. There are shape differences between these dendrites. They are subtle, but they do exist. Let's see if we can find out whether there is some difference clinically. So as I said, it's a waste paper basket diagnosis. Herpes zoster can give you something like this, neurotrophic epithelopathy, which comes after an HSV infection is long since gone away. Acanthamoeba can mimic anything. It can mimic fungus, it can mimic the viral, so you can get pseudodendrites there. An epithelial defect, which is healing, can give you a sort of pseudodendritic pattern. typically a nail injury, which is their fingernail injury in a zigzag manner, sometimes might mimic a pseudodendrite, dendrite as it's healing. And of course, a recurrent erosion syndrome. So it's a bit of a misnomer. We call them pseudodendrites just because their origin is not herpes. They're actual dendrites. So some of the characteristics which differentiate them from herpes, I would say instead of calling them pseudodendrites, we call it varicella zoster dendrites. VZV dendrites stain very minimally. They don't stain that bright green stain that you get in dendrites. Then it has a stuck-on appearance. If you remember what I told you about the actual dendrites, the epithelium heaping up on the sides and the center, there is a like an ulcer which goes up to the basement membrane. Here, this looks like one of those microsporidia type things where it's stuck to the top of the cornea as if somebody has glued it with Fevicol. It's a little bump on the top. And it can take on a Medusa-like form. Medusa was a Greek goddess with snakes in the hair. Many branches, but lack of end bulbs. And it's typically found in the periphery of the cornea, unlike the HSV, which can be anywhere, but usually in the center. And they're more superficial, and that central ulcer that I told you about is not there. So there are a few subtle signs which can bring you to distinguish between the two. In neurotrophic epitheliopathy, neurotrophic is typically, as I said, the HSV keratitis, which has healed, but the epithelium has not healed. And we keep on bombarding them with antivirals and worsen the cause. So the pseudodendrite is often in the interpalpebral area. So this is not like the herpes zoster. So this, because this is a healing or a non-healing ulcer from a HSV infection. So it occupies the same place as an HSV would. So it's in the interpalpebral area. Patient gives you a history of having been treated with oral, topical, or both antivirals. So you suspect this if a patient has undergone antiviral treatment for 2 weeks or more, and now this is the picture that you're seeing. While in acanthamoeba, there may be history of contact lens wear or poor hygiene, and the swimming in the south, farmers walking and working in muddy water, like in rice plantations, they get acanthamoeba. So that sort of history is there. The symptoms are out of proportion to the clinical appearance. So in virus, usually it's in proportion. In acanthamoeba, it's out of proportion in the other way. The pain is so much and the clinical appearance is hardly any. It's opposite of fungal. With fungal, the patient's clinical appearance is horrible and the patient doesn't complain of much pain. So this is how you can distinguish it just on the pain. And the pseudodendrites can appear as granular cystic appearing epithelium and little or no stromal inflammation. So you see this almost looking like a dystrophy over there. What about abrasions, I told you, or which are healing, or the recurrent epithelial erosions? They'll give you a proper history of an injury, minor injury, waking up at night or first awakening with sudden pain. So the history is a dead giveaway in these cases. To summarize, you take a proper history, have a strong index of suspicion, stain every lesion. Please, fluorescein is cheap and available in our country. And see on slit lamp under high power, look for the classical signs. If in doubt, you scrape and stain in a lab with pap smear or GIMSA. And don't overtreat an epithelial lesion with antivirals beyond 2 weeks. Think in terms of either keratitis medicamentosa or even neurotrophic. Stop everything, put them on lubricants, and later on you can add soft steroids in the treatment. Thank you so much for your attention.